Welcome to Downtown Variety, presented by La MaMa and Culture Hub. I'm your host, Mattie Barber-Bockelman, and here I am again, live from my living room in Brooklyn, New York. It is July 3rd, 2020, and Downtown Variety is a live online performance series that La MaMa and Culture Hub started on March 20th, 2020, when the city shut down, and it was born out of necessity. Since then, we've connected with over 100 artists using LiveLab, which is a browser-based media router for collaborative performance that CultureHub, which is an art and technology community based at La MaMa, has been developing to reach out to our international collaborators, peers, and audiences. This week, tonight, right now, we are going to connect live with artists from Los Angeles, San Francisco, Seattle, Barcelona, Spain, and Bremen, Germany, with video art that will take us to Sao Paulo, Brazil, and oh my God, and Seoul, Korea. We're all over the place here, okay, but we're here. And excuse my French, but these performers are all fucking incredible. We have really gone through a process with each of them, and they've adjusted and responded to the technology and fine-tuned their storytelling and made real, real magic out of their living spaces and homes. So I'm here in my home, and I'm glad you're here. And we've got a beautiful performer who's joining us right now from Germany, where it is currently 2 a.m. So without further ado, the first Davis of the night, I give you Aaron Samuel Davis.
What a crime that I am born to make. What a crime that I am born to make. What a crime that I am born to make. Run down, Jackson, Jackson,
prettiest train that a man has ever seen, and I go to Jackson River beyond me. Lay your head on a man that can't be seen, and he goes to Jackson River beyond me. Prettiest train that a man has ever seen, and I go to Jackson River beyond me. Lay your head on a man that can't be seen, and he goes to Jackson River beyond the reef. Where he has changed that a man has ever seen. And he goes to Jackson River beyond the reef. Lay your head on a man that can't be seen, and it goes to Jackson River beyond the reef. Prettiest train that a man has ever seen. And it goes to Jackson River beyond me. Lay your head on a man that can't be seen. And it goes to Jackson River beyond me. Prettiest dream that a man has ever seen.
And wow, on his tooth in Germany, and we're about to see his beautiful face. And wow, I mean, we're going to be in a lot of different time zones tonight, but we just thought it would be only kind to do the latest first. Because if I'm not mistaken, this individual has a performance tomorrow.
It's true.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
How's it going?
It's going all right. Good morning over here.
Oh, and yes, good morning. But it really should be.
Good evening.
How are you? How is it in Germany? What's going on there?
Yes, well, at the moment, everyone is kind of resting, but people are outside still walking. It's a Saturday early morning. The climate is quite cool, but a bit humid, but still things are afloat.
You're in a turtleneck and a jacket.
Exactly. But I'm also like, I wear turtlenecks and jackets and boots in the summer. It's a thing. I don't know. But the moon is full and the energy is quite peaceful at the moment.
Nice. And you guys are, you're performing. How is that happening?
Mm-hmm. So I'm currently working in Bremen and at the theater here. And it's true. We are able to perform. We're doing open air performances. And it's quite a luxury and a gift to be able to see and share with the audiences. Of course, they have distance and things are outdoors. Mm-hmm. So if it rains, the show won't happen. But if the weather is good, then we'll be able to perform as well.
Yeah, almost more like baseball.
Exactly.
More like the sports.
Yes. Of course, the audience takes their distance, but so does do the performers.
Beautiful. Well, I'm so, so happy that we got to connect with you today and you took us all over your apartment. We were trying to find the right space for this. We went to the attic, to the stairs, to the porch.
Yes.
And luckily the cat did make a surprise appearance.
Yeah.
Thank goodness.
Laser.
That's the name?
Yes, Laser is her name.
Beautiful. Yeah. Cool. Well, Aaron.
Thank you so much, Maddie, for the opportunity.
Yeah, thank you for coming.
Yeah, I'll be watching the rest from the bed.
Yes, and thanks to your stagehand who did a very
Hando.
Yes. Cool. All right, and beautiful. Give yourself a fade out, as they say.
Yes.
Cool. All right. So. Aaron Samuel Davis, who's an incredible performer and is originally from the States, but is based in Germany now. So yes, now we're gonna go to another artist who's given us video art. You may recognize her name. Her name is Lívia Sá, and she is CultureHub's photographer, one of our greatest photographers. And so if you've ever been to an event in the CultureHub studio in the past few years, it's likely that you saw her sneaking around the space, grabbing masterful shots in impossible conditions, because basically everything we do has no light. But this piece and the pieces you're going to see tonight, we're so excited to share on Downtown Variety her work. The first piece is called Resist Exist, and it's a short film shot on Super 8. And it documents everyday scenes that juxtapose with scenes of resistance from different indigenous communities during a protest in Sao Paulo, Brazil. So here's Lívia's work.
Eu como liderança feminina, eu luto pela terra. Eu defendo a terra para o meu povo indígena. Está tudo destruído. Grande ruralista destruiu a nossa terra tradicionais. Nós não temos mais nem remédios medicinais para a gente usar, para a gente fazer o remédio, para a gente tomar. Nós não temos mais mato para caçar, nós não temos mais rio para poder se pescar. Nós vivemos pedindo a esmola para o governo brasileiro. Antigamente a gente não vivia assim. Antigamente a gente vivia muito bem, muito tranquilo. Mas hoje em dia nós estamos vivendo numa chiqueiro.
mais. Galera, povos que protegem a floresta. Se pegar as unidades de conservação e de proteção, já foi reconhecido no mundo inteiro que os povos indígenas são os melhores defensores da mãe terra, do mundo inteiro.
Ten little Indians went out to dine. One choked his little self, and then there were nine. Nine little Indians sat up late. One overslept, and then there were eight. Eight little Indians gayest under heaven. One went to sleep, and then there were seven. Seven little Indians chopping up sticks. One chopped himself in half, and then there were six. Six little Indians playing with a hive. A bumblebee stung one, and then there were five. Five little Indians on a cellar door. One tumbled in, and then there were four. Four little Indians going out to sea. A red herring swallowed one of them, and then there were three. Three little Indians walking in a zoo. A big bear hugged one, and then there were two. Two little Indians sitting in the sun. One got all frizzled up, and then there was one. One little Indian left all alone. He went and hung himself, and then there were none. A sour poetry rooted in white supremacy told the story of manifest destiny and the inevitability of indigenous removal. A new narrative evolved. Reports from the Western Front began to speak of white supremacy over the dark-skinned savages. The untamed wilderness of America was being subdued by the white God and white authority. A strange thing happened almost overnight. The savages, powerless and nearly extinct, were knighted a kind of nobility. The noble savage became the newest mythology. To ease the mind of guilty whites, a form of humanity was granted to the almost dead. The great enemy, now powerless and subdued, became a pet, a token of American flex. Regulated to the corners of forgotten land, we suffered on the edges of American expand. Disease, lack of opportunity, poverty, poor education, and dysfunction all allowed the destruction of a spiritual system that and way of life which sustained our people for a millennia. Broken in half, we lived on psychic scraps. We became easy victims. We became easy victims. We became easy victims for the military and missionary industrial complex, scooped up and forced into white clothes and white names if we wanted to eat. Our children were stolen and forced in re-education camps. Boarding schools were hair and culture were cut off. These camps run by brutal Christian cults trained us to be submissive servants through abuse and neglect. When the camp's brutality came to light, the camps faded from sight. A new plan to place every indigenous child into white hands. By 1970, 35% of all indigenous children in America had been removed from homes of their birth and culture and placed with whites. White dominators embraced the new role of savior. They rode in to plant Christian values in the soil of our wounded psyche. I was one of those kids, taken from my mother and tribe in 1966, placed into blank America. I grew up on the strange, penny dreadful story of who I was and where I came from. They taught me the fantasy that my white father and the Mormon church had saved me from a poverty snuff porn of reservation life. 33 years late, I went to the mountain for days. I frizzled in the sun on a bed of mugwort and sage. My gums bled and I prayed for an exorcism. Tendrils of white snaked my brain. The blood of my dark ancestors beat my ears. I was neither wolf nor dog, a colonial junkyard mutt, rabid fever, sweat pours until there is no more. No water, only sun and heat, and this granite slab. And I sway and I sink into stone. And I sink into stone. And I sink into stone. And the ancestors whisper in languages I cannot decipher. Bago, bago, my blood drums, bago. And I am the black rock. I am the black rock. And my blood drums, I am the black rock. And I am splitting. I am splitting. I am splitting. And I am thunder. And I am lightning. And I am the mountain. And the mountain says, forgive. Forgive all of this. Forgive and carve a new world. Oh.
Timothy White Eagle.
Hello, Mattie.
Hey.
Hey.
You're in Seattle.
I'm in Seattle.
How are you?
I'm good. I am. I'm good. I'm blessed.
Man, yeah. So for people who are watching at home, Timothy yesterday came with a piece that was focused just on this printer and this printed image and this, and then the text. And then today we were expecting to have Timothy's feed pop in with that focused on the printer again, but instead we saw Timothy's face in this thing. And you created that all today, right?
Oh yeah.
Which, you know, I guess is par for your course, but wow.
Yeah. Thank you.
What have you been? So you've been doing stuff on Fridays during quarantine?
Yeah, I started an Instagram show that is at 7 o'clock every Friday, timothy.whiteeagle on Instagram. And it's public access ritual performance art. So I have some parameters. I allow myself only Friday to work on it. So I build something. I think about it all week, but I don't take notes. And it's kind of an experiment in being alive in front of a performance when nobody else is there with you. And so what the performance is what I think of in the moment and what I prepped, what I could create that day. But it's really an experiment for me to reach back to my roots of being a club kid and hosting drag shows. Mm. And trying to reconnect with my sense of improvisation and on the spot humor, which I was quite good at when I was like 25, 30 and, you know, doing hosting drag shows and stuff. But my work had gotten to a place where there's a lot of gravitas in my work. And so I really wanted to explore something that I allowed myself to be silly, to be imperfect, and to be alive in the moment. And so that's what I'm doing with the Instagram. And it's more of a workshop than a polished performance, but it's been a great tool for me to re-engage part of my performance skill set that I haven't used in a while, or in such a direct way.
Yeah, that's amazing. And yeah, I feel like there's been sort of an idea of, okay, in quarantine, you can finally have all the time that you need to create your, you know, opus?
Magnus.
Yeah, that one. I was going to say Magnus Opus, but that's probably some guy. But yeah, to take this opportunity as a time for iteration and liveness, which it seems so disconnected because we're all just sitting in our homes.
Right.
And what about that is live? But there's something.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I had, you know, COVID cut off. I had a show that was going to premiere at On the Boards here in Seattle. And we were, you know, 2 weeks from opening when we got closed down and indefinitely postponed. Oh. So I had my magnum opus ready to go. We were just getting to that really juicy part of the rehearsal process where things were really starting to click.
Damn.
And really starting to feel solid. And the set was just starting to be built, and it was going to be amazing. And things were really coming together. And then it was just like, put the brakes on it. And so I think I wanted to do something that was also opposite of that, opposite of all of the work and preparation, and just have fun and be alive. And, you know, I have some other ulterior motives. I have a lot of feelings about spirituality and the fact that Christian culture has taken spirituality, Christian culture and New Age culture has turned so many people off from the ideas of prayer and manifestation through stating your intent. And so one of the points of my show, there's an element to it that's ritual, and it's ridiculous and also very sincere ritual and prayer that goes on during the show. And I'm just trying to illustrate my personal belief, which is that the new world that we want to dream of has to be created from a place of play. And yes, we need time to process our trauma, but that the place of trauma and victimhood is not the place to start dreaming of the new world. We need to be in a place that's free from victim status and perpetrator status and create something new. Otherwise, we're going to recreate victim and perpetrator, at least a personal belief. So I'm just exploring these ideas and offering one way of being with spirit that is hopefully without dogma and without the heaviness of both heavy tradition and like the sort of new age stuff that sprouts and is so often about somebody trying to make money.
Wow, I can't wait to watch, because I feel like that's just, I don't know, that sounds, makes so much sense to me just when it hits me, but I don't know any of that really. I've never, I don't know.
Yeah. I think a lot of us are really
empathy so much. And we are going to go to, yes, we are going to go to Huntress Janos, who is a incredible artist that we're connecting with in Los Angeles. There's no sound. Oh, I hear. Cool. We just had a potential maybe audio glitch, but we're back. So we're about to do something kind of wild. We're getting Huntress, who is, a lot is happening. So Sangmin, let's go to the up next and we'll get Huntress. Cool.
Echoless and benefit, a nebulous excellence, reset the emphasis on helpfulness and healthfulness. A reverence for endlessness makes eloquence and eminence, deliverance to equivalency, whoever exodus is generous. This is the ant chant. We'd be chewing up plants and transplanting, expanding and dancing, we're advancing, enhancing and branching, penchant for enchanting. Hive mind understanding, granted I'm ranting. Answer outstanding, notwithstanding the queen, commanders commanding, so demanding, pedantic antics, fantastic, romantics, phantoms, handsome, slanted, you're so handsome, held some ants for ransom, purchase and refinance them, inject and implant them. we must be porous. We must be porous, don't trust me to restore us. I prefer to know the course, I prefer to know thesaurus. Return to planetary Taurus, it's imaginary for us. Too many angles, it strangles. Pythagoras, newfangled Orus. Entangled, amorphous before us, as diasporus, restores, explores for you. Dinosaurs, wars, horrors, categories, territories, inventories for glories before these shorties become divorcees, so boring. At least no sororities from orgies, chlorine, and fluorine. What I mean is I'm floating higher than morphine and coding. Call me an, hacker, I'm coding. Put on a jacket, I'm coding. It's wild what I'm undergoing. Please don't be so controlling. Installed an app that's all-knowing. Just wait a second, it's loading. Oh, I'm getting a call, too. Hello?
Maddie.
Hi, Maddie.
Hey, how are you? Just so you know, we lost your sound a little bit, but you're back now, I think.
Oh, yay. Then should I continue saying the rhymes?
Rhyme it up.
Okay. The reflected perspective, projected subjective, respected selective, protected elective, objected defective. Introspective directives might prove more effective than expected directions. I've perfected the effect of connected addictives, though dissected the festive and infected the victors. Their victims convicted, their systems constricted, their millions, their twisted jurisdictions all vintage. Your image in print is imprinted of fiction. Kingdom's clientage, a linkage to sickness. Who could have did this? Predictors bewildered. Your image in print is imprinted of fiction. I'll give this to your richness, your Christmas, your stillness. I'll pass with the quickness, leave you stinging like citrus. Catch the snitch on my nimbus, cause my vision is vicious. You can visit Mount Olympus, stay a minute, be religious. But up here it's physics.
Where are you?
I'm at my friend's house.
In Los Angeles?
Yeah, in Los Angeles.
How tall are you?
6'5".
How tall do you think I am?
I have no idea. I'm maybe 5'8".
Go 2 inches higher and you got it.
Ah, close. 5'10".
Go again. Go again.
Yeah, keep going.
Go
Show
on,
them
yeah.
an emotion. Evolution promotion. Digitally, unawoken. Clown or a comedian, revive your lens from violent environments. The higher sits in silence. Who am I again? Who is I again? And I am niacin. And I'm missing what I'm missing, Miss Singer, because I'm a sinner. The vitamin Leviathan, the science of desire, administered, acquired, bad administered, purified, more like sinister satire. Paradise, I pass the fire, search scorching red-hot occupier, an afterthought, an amplifier. Quantum chameleon, I'm silly and I'm serious. Comedian, hysterical, mind black as obsidian. I'm hailing from oblivion. I'm alien, yet simian. Scary, cute, and merry, but I'm angry. It's Alvarian, experimental gradients. Birthing at my burial, I'm buried in hysteria. Precarious materials, bacterial delirium. How's that one? Chaos, essay on a seance.
You can rhyme.
Chaos, essay on a seance. Heinous oasis, a greatest place in stasis. Las Vegas mosaic of pathos archaic. Rayon today are away in a halo. Starpit liaisons, this is the prayon. The famous prayon Amadeus Himalayas on the way ice crazes. Stand my crayons. That's right, chaos, chaos, chaos.
What are you wearing?
I'm wearing Roa.
What is
it's my friend. It's a my friend's house who I'm chilling at.
Oh, nice. That's what you're wearing on your physical body. What about on your digital body?
On my digital body, I'm wearing a filter that I made called Moorish Mandible. It's about, like, the use of the black form, and it's sculpture. The sculptures that it features is Henry Moore's sculptures, the woman reclining.
Beautiful.
Thank you, yo.
You got something else?
Absolutely. I've got hella things. Like Queer Invader. My watch is a calculator. It's a useful indicator. Mathematics operator. Zero is the divine creator. Infinity generator. Life is just an oscillator. Living in a simulator. Random number generator. Everything originator. Particle accelerator. Thinking like an innovator. Yeah, I'm your queer invader. I arrived here in a crater. Vatasife aviator. Human life collaborator. Alien life integrator. Interstellar navigator. Climb into my incubator. Consciousness illuminator. This world needs a renovator. Plant life reanimator. Space age administrator. Conservation coordinator. Yeah, I'm your queer invader. I've got teeth like an alligator, some call me an aggregator, situation escalator, straight hater, illustrator, anti-fascist demonstrator, pop science commentator, educator, instigator, colorful legislator, political regulator. I'm your queer invader. define Orion, a drawing divine, an iron enlightened, make it so, love the show, space is whole, void is home. There's another rhyme, and that one also continues. It goes, live long and prosper, zero gravity posture, a Vulcan imposter, curiosity fosters, Spock's on my roster, space chest is foster. Next generation is swerving, constellation emergence, location is urgent, destination submersion. Formation, resurgence, representation, conversion. Yay. Yeah, I'm having a blast. Yeah. Pedantic antics, fantastic romantics, tantrum slanted, you're so handsome. yeah. I just have a blast doing all of these.
I have a feeling you're endless.
thank you. Thanks so much.
Do you have hope? Are you hopeful?
Yeah, I mean, I like, I'm definitely like feeling the transformations that are happening like every day. And I just have been really like glad to be a part of them. Like absolutely, like this, I wrote a very political rhyme recently called Helicopter Monsters. And it's because I really don't like how many cop helicopters are flying around. It goes like this. Drop these, stop these helicopter monsters. LA copper choppers constantly launching stalkers. Honored dollars prompting slaughters. Doctors and daughters. Stopper, locker up, chopper up proper. Yeah? Captures become fractures. Cracker catchers of rappers. Captors will be lashing at manufacturing scraps distractors. Cracker catchers of rappers. Draining water, princess popper. Impacting the blacker who'd rather greener pasture. Improper, unless she's picking cotton. Sharecroppers pressing harder, chokers prosper. Orders of porcine slobbering macabre, black Laura Palmer, imposters, opera, optics, adopt Compton stomping, stop the auction, wait till it's forgotten, then hop back on board, constantly rotten, common wanton sides, prompting gardens of coffins, losses aside, coughing up demise, toxins assigned by profit paradigms, margins, confinement and violence align intertwinement, resign the tyrants whose crimes go silent, defiant insight and blinding sirens, climate, giant malignment, climbing declined enshrinements. Yes, that was actually my newest rhyme that I wrote.
Huntress, you're amazing.
Oh, thank you, yo.
Want to take us out?
Yes.
End it.
Hive mind understanding. This is the ant chant. We be chewing up plants and transplanting. Expanding and dancing, advancing. We're enhancing and branching. Penchant for enchanting. Granted, I'm ranting. Hive mind understanding. Ants are outstanding. Commanders commanding, so demanding, pedantic antics, fantastic romantics, phantom tantrum slanted, you're so handsome. Held some ants for ransom, purchase and refinance them, inject and implant them. Bye, yo. Thanks for having me.
Dia 14 de março de 2018, eu fui mais uma vez assassinada. É porque quando morre uma de nós, somos todas machucadas. Ensanguentada, caminhando continuo. Minha voz, ao invés de morta, cada vez mais aumentada, virou um grito. Um grito que assusta o promotor, o juiz, o miliciano e o mito. Um grito de dor do parto. Do momento de partir. Parece mais um grito de dor do parto do momento de parir. Da sua arma, o que saíram foram sementes que se espalharam e brotaram no coração de tanta gente que me sinto mais viva até do que eu era antigamente. O seu jornal falou: deixa, só mais uma negra assassinada, deve ser piranha viciada. Mas na sua burrice de macho branco, você se esqueceu. Ao tentar matar a deusa orixá, foi você quem faleceu. E o canto da guerreira, pra te agoniar, todos os dias você vai ouvir. Quem matou Marielle Franco, nós vamos descobrir. Thank you.
찾고 있는데 왜 나만 혼자인 걸까 오늘 하루가 지나가면 내일 하루 중엔 내가 있을까 일렁이는 이 바람 타고서
Hey.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm doing great.
Where are you?
I'm doing great. Oh, guess where am I?
I have a pretty good idea.
Uh-huh.
Okay, big reveal. It's Seoul, Korea, but what neighborhood are you in?
Yeah, I'm in Seoul. And yeah. It's around my studio.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I went to a convenience store right now.
So good. So just so you know, because we had a little sound error at the beginning when your sound came on, but so I want everybody to know that this is Anna Kang, who wrote that whole song and performed that whole song, and this is her, and that was her in her studio. So what was it like sort of coming up with that story to go along with the song that you had written?
Oh, so the title of this song is 내 마음 콩, which means when you are crushed on someone or like you're attracted to someone,
uh-huh.
In Korea we'll like boom. In Korea we say that 마음이 콩, or kung, shim kung. So I want to describe the attraction about someone with this song.
Cool, so it's like you were writing a little letter to the person who you're sort of singing about in that song?
Exactly, you got it.
Nice. And then did you actually go into a store and get something there? What was the drink that you put down?
Yeah, I bought a coffee for someone.
Do you think somebody's going to pick it up later today and read the note?
Maybe later. I don't know who would be the one, but I hope so.
That's funny. I wonder if anything will come of that. And you graduated from Seoul Institute of the Arts, right?
Right. Yeah, 1 year ago.
Yeah, and Seoul Institute of the Arts is a long time collaborator of LaMama, we don't have sound again. And
you cannot hear me?
I can hear you, but I'm wondering if the live stream is getting
okay.
But the Seoul Institute of the Arts, which is a longtime collaborator and is where you went to school and where we met in New York a couple years ago.
In like 2019, I guess.
Yeah. Great. Okay, so thank you so much for taking us around Seoul. And for doing all of this. What time is it there right now?
It's almost 10 a.m.
Yeah. Nice. So we had 2 a.m., we had 10 a.m., we had 6 p.m. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Anna. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me.
Yes. Cool. So now we've got a performer coming at us live from the West Coast. We're going back to Los Angeles, California. We're definitely favoring the West Coast in this edition, which is exciting for us because we've got CultureHub Los Angeles brought in a couple of these artists, which is really exciting. So great. We ready to go with this next performance? Yes, yes. Cool. Okay. So, without further ado, I give you Shauna Davis.
Mm-hmm. yours sincere, I'm feeling like a million. And I want to get this over to you, that I'm feeling like a million. Though I haven't got a villa, a dugout, or a bed, still I'm walking like a million. With my hat on the side of my head, what is this thing that I've found? Through the days that I've clowned, is it you that's around? I got a crazy feeling I could jump up to the ceiling, cause I'm feeling like a million. Though I couldn't buy a collar, a necktie, or a glove, still I'm feeling like a million. Is it you? Is it me? Is it love? Though I'm flat, though I'm broke, though I'm bent, I'm contented to never sigh as time goes by. There's a gleam in my eye, and inside of my heart I'm a lucky guy. There's a reason why I'm feeling like a million. Though I haven't got a collar, a shilling or a sou, still I'm feeling like a million. And I want to get this over to you, that I'm feeling like a million. Though I haven't got a villa, a dugout or a bed, still I'm walking like a million. With my hat on the side of my head, what is this thing that I found? Through the days that I've clowned, is it you I found? I got a crazy feeling I could jump up to the ceiling, cause I'm feeling like a million. Though I couldn't buy a collar, a necktie, or a glove, still I'm feeling like a million. Is it you? Is it me? Is it love?
I guess lemons are the new currency. So I brought them. I don't know. I just felt like I might need these if I was going to talk to you. I just got a funny feeling somehow. I don't know exactly why, but you know.
Yeah.
Hey, Shauna.
Lemon. Quarantine. Hello.
A lemon.
I'm glad you could. Hey.
It's just like.
Yeah.
You could just do the handoff, you know?
Totally. Ideally, they'd be flying from here and there and everywhere.
Should I throw one to you?
Yeah.
You'll have to catch it, though.
Right.
Okay, ready?
Actually, ready? Drop it down.
I'm just going to do it. Oh, I'm going to drop it. Okay. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, nice. Amazing.
Thank you.
So good.
Yes.
So good. Where's it coming from? Where are these lemons? What's the yellow? What's the story here, Shauna?
Just my imagination. It's July 4th weekend, and some of us are thinking about freedom. And in an attempt to not respond to red, white, and blue patriotism, mm-hmm. and things like that, I wanted to tap into a different world where things are yellow.
And incredible. Pleasant. Yes.
Yeah.
What was it like creating that in your home? If this is your home.
There, it is my home.
Very good.
There's a lot of lemon juice on the ground. So kind of sticky.
Mm.
But also really nice to just dance. And let go. Yeah. And to go tap into something else than what's happening right now.
Yeah. I mean, definitely, there's so many moments of joy as a viewer. And I know it made me think about, oh, what are all the yellow things in my apartment and right by me? And even that's a fun little exercise to just start flashing
yeah.
the yellow things.
I didn't know how much yellow I had until a few years ago when putting all this together, but there's a lot.
Cool. And you're in Los Angeles, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And we got connected to Shauna through a couple of people who had been on Downtown Variety a few weeks ago, Chris and Lauda. And I don't know if I got to tell you, did I tell you this? Yeah, I think I did, that I ran into them on the street the other day.
No.
I was just walking around, you know, just walking around, and I had followed my legs, followed my nose, just gone wherever, and then finally was coming home, and then somebody walking by me was like, Mattie? And I was like, huh? And I looked at this person's face, and I was like, excuse me? And
her face like this, yeah. Right?
And so he had to take off his mask, and I was like, oh!
Yeah, that's happened to me too many times, where I'm like, they say Shauna, and I'm like,
at least we have the mask excuse, though, is a pretty good one.
For sure.
That's a disguise. That's a straight up disguise.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, Shauna Davis, so sunshiny and beautiful, and your movement and your face is, all of it is amazing and so fun to watch. And I'm so glad that we got to work on it with you and see it evolve over the past week or so.
Yes, thank you for having me.
That's yes. Nice. Can't wait to see what's next. All right, Shauna, thanks so much. Shauna Davis. Oh, yeah, and that was the second Davis of the evening. We had one dancing Davis, Aaron Samuel Davis, and here's another dancing Davis, Shauna Davis. So, cool.
Yes, all right. Shauna,
thanks so much.
Bye.
Okay, so I thought it was going to definitely rain at some point in the show, and I don't think it has yet, but somebody's got their umbrella out. And it's been thundering and had a little bit of lightning. So our show, what incredible artists. Cool. So next up, I think this is where we're at. We have our last artist for the night, the next artist. Okay, can you hear me? Hello?
It's weird. Can you hear me? What? Okay, that's weird. Let's see, meeting ID 12031996.
Hola.
Hola. Hola. I was just about to leave. Are you the teacher?
What?
No, oh, sorry. I thought you might have been the teacher.
What do you mean by teacher?
Yoga. You're here for the 5 p.m. vinyasa class, no?
No. It's 3 a.m. here. I thought I was going to a costume party.
Wait, really? That's weird. I must have the wrong meeting. Wait, you're going to a costume party at 2 a.m.? Where are you?
Well, yes, it's a costume party. I'm in Barcelona. Where are you?
I'm in San Francisco. Wait, really? Spain?
Yeah.
I was just there last year when the world was open.
Yeah.
I love it there. Well, I mean, that explains the party at 2 a.m., right? I mean, you guys don't even eat lunch until midnight.
Yes. I'm so sorry. I'm so confused. Maybe I had the wrong ID.
Or no, or I probably did. Let's see. I got 12031996 restorative vinyasa class.
Wait.
I'm sorry. Go ahead. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
What was that? The number you said?
The meeting ID?
Yes.
12031996.
This is the day I was born.
What?
Yeah.
No, wait. 12/03/1996. Your birthday is December 3rd?
No, 12th of March, 1996, day first. You Americans are crazy.
Yeah, but that's amazing, no?
It's magical. Sorry, can I see you? I want to make sure you exist.
You want to make sure I exist? I love that, yeah. Me first?
No, together. Okay. I will count to three, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Tres. Dos.
Dos. Uno.
Uno. Well.
Hola.
Hello, stranger. So, what should we do?
What should we do? I don't know. That's a good question.
Yeah, maybe that's it. We can ask each other questions.
Okay, I mean, that's not what I meant, but okay.
Okay, so I go first.
Okay.
Tell me a happy memory.
A happy memory. It's funny, I just asked this question in a show I did last week. I'm a performer. Mainly just for Sam Rudy, but yeah, I'm a performer. okay, a memory. I was 12. And I was with my best friends, Alan and Andrew, and it's like the summer before eighth grade, right? So 1984 or 85. Anyways, we had just missed the bus by seconds, right? The back of the bus would turn the corner just as we came up. And we were pissed, right? Because, I mean, we're 12. We couldn't do nothing but just sit and wait for an entire hour until the next one came. So we just sat on our skateboards, talked about girls and made jokes. and made jokes about our fucking dicks and just